Good afternoon. Morning. Today we are going to discuss about this particular phase transformation in the metal, that is also known as the isothermal transformation, and it is just one step above the understanding of the phase diagram that we discuss from this as well, the iron carbon phase diagram, from where we can identify at the various composition range and the temperature range the transformation is taking place, and the microconstituent of the material changes from one phase to another and creating another kind of a material, either with respect to the carbon percentage it is either softer or harder. So as you can see, just we are just now summarizing this particular lecture regarding this understanding of this particular iron carbon phase diagram. So to understand this particular phase diagram, we are just taking a look for a revision of this, and then we will further move for our next isothermal transformation diagram. So what is all about this, and why we need of this particular phase diagram. So just as you can see in this particular figure, you can understand that the particular understanding of this iron carbon diagram that is showing basically the understanding of transformation, that at a various temperature the transformation is taking place, that the alpha ferrite combining with the carbon is moving towards the another kind of you can say creating a material. This is the particular region of the basically you can say the low carbon and mild carbon, a medium carbon alloys, that is called the hypoeutectoid steel, that is having the range up to 0.83%, and above this 0.83 to 2%, that is called the combination of the high carbon alloy steel, that is the containing the perlite. Perlite is the very softer form of the iron solution, and that the, when it combined with the cementite means the percentage of the carbon is increasing, and that is related to the cementite combination, and that is the transformation basically you can see here is happening, means that particular material which is having less percentage of carbon possessing a very soft materials, and when it is combined with the percentage of higher carbon it possessing the harder material, as you can see in this particular figure. And that basic transformation of that particular transformation is also showing, and you can understand. So I can just remind this particular figure, basically phase diagram, to understand the definition of this particular phase understanding. So this particular iron carbon phase diagram is very important to understand, and this left hand side is showing the particular temperature of the material in the Fahrenheit, and that is in the right hand side it is showing in the degree centigrade, and below that particular percentage of the carbon is basically identified, and above that understanding is to understand the basically you can say the steel percentage and the carbon percentage, how this carbon percentage play a very vital role to change the property of the material, and this particular phase transformation basically happening, and this due to that changes in the phase phases due to the cooling and heating, the various kind of micro constituents are developed, as you can see in this particular figure. This particular phase is the combination of the alpha, gamma and the liquid solution, and that is the phase by which the when the temperature is get below it will transform into that particular austenite and the perlite, as well as the cementite, when the percentage of the carbon will increase. So in that similar way, when the temperature will get down to this particular location, the transformation of the material is changes. As we talked in this particular iron carbon phase diagram, there are the basic three kind of reaction is taking place. First one is the eutectic, second is the eutectoid, and another one is the pretectic reaction. So that is pretectic is very similar to the eutectic, but most of the time we are focusing on the pretectic and eutectoid reactions. that the protective creation is nothing just a combination of the liquid and solid, which is creating a kind of a new solid, and the eutectoid, which is relating to the combination of the two solid creating a third single solid. So that particular differentiation we discussed in the earlier lecture, to understand the phase diagram, how that particular temperature play a very vital role to transform the one phase to the another phase. As you can see at that particular blue C, that is the particular showing the liquid phase of the material, that is the combination of the hydrogen and carbon, and that the particular phase, that the particular red line, that the particular line is showing here at that temperature approximately 1492 degree centigrade, which is shown here as well. So that particular temperature is showing the liquidus line, solidus line, and the liquidus line, from where the liquid is transforming into the solid, and that the transformation is basically happening as this, the perpendicular lines A, E, B is showing here, that is showing the transformation of the material with respect to the composition of the carbon in the material is taking place, that the transformation is happening. As you can see that the, when the cooling of the material is happening, what is happening over here from the point A, that the point A we are considering, the transformation is basically taking place, and that is the transformation is happening when the material temperature is cooling down and the particular liquid is transforming at a higher temperature into delta ferrite, and delta ferrite combining with this gamma ferrite, and that gamma ferrite is basically nothing just and the form of the solid solution, and that the transformation is also happening when the temperature below the gamma temperature, that is the austenite temperature, and that austenite temperature is transforming to perform a various kind of a solid material, and that is the eutectic transformation basically is happening at 727 degrees centigrade, and that the point is basically called the eutectoid point. At the very lower temperature the eutectoid point is happening, and that temperature basically what is happened, that so this whole phase diagram is nothing just to understand how the material gets freeze and changes their microstructure with respect to their microconstituents, and these microconstituents development of the microstructure leading to the various property of the material, as the material which is you can say the steel and the cast iron. So we are just focusing on this particular steel. As you can see the below, the hypereutectoid and the hyper-eutectoid is happening in the steel as well. So this phase diagram is nothing just this explanation of the development of the microstructure with help of this microconstituent at a various level of the temperature and the composition of the carbon. So when the temperature gets below, the transformation from one phase to another phase is happening, and it is the vice versa in the case of the heat treatment process, but not up to the melting temperature, but up to a certain recrystallization temperature, from where we can alter the material's properties or enhance the property of the material, that we will cover in the topic of the heat treatment. So this is just the understanding of the phase diagram that we discussed, and you can see here the particular phases, what are the combination of the Fe3C, and the liquid is happening over here, and this is the particular eutectic portion where from the austenite and the cementite is taking place. So when this combination of the microstructures or the solid solution or the liquid solid solution phases are combining, what are happening, the material gets its properties enhanced or improved property. So that's why we are studying this phase diagram. So this phase diagram is just the understanding of the behavior of the microstructural changes that related to the property of the material. So these microconstituent we will discuss one by one in the detail, but just to understand, I am just showing this figure that the phase diagram of the iron carbon is locating at this particular, and when the temperature is gets below, the combination of the various phases which is transforming from one phase to another, creating a kind of a micro constituent with the combination of the carbon percentage and creating the different kind of a micro structure which is leading to the mechanical property of the material. So that property is basically related to the various kind of a steel, and that steel is showing with the carbon percentage. So this is just the understanding of this carbon alloy system. And now we are further moving to understand this particular, the isothermal transformation of this particular. So why do we study this transformation in the metal? So when we understand the development, that is the set of desirable mechanical characteristics of a material, and that often result from a phase transformation, which is work that is a heat treatment as well. So the time and the temperature dependence of some phase transformation are conventionally represented or modified phase diagram, which was not indicated in this particular iron phase carbon diagram. So that's why we are studying this isothermal phase diagram, to understand the transformation time basically. So basic funda kya hai phase diagram ko understand karne ka, isothermal that is the phase transformation, the isothermal phase transformation, that is basically known as a triple T diagram. It is just because in these kind of phase diagram, with that the iron carbon diagram, the transformation time is not showing, that how much time this transformation is taking place to convert that particular liquid phase into the liquid solid phase, and that liquid solid phase into the particular solid phase, or that particular solid phase into the two solid phases. So that is not mentioning the how much time is taking in this particular phase transformation. So for overcoming and to understanding this transformation, we are now considering this isothermal phase transformation diagram to understand the time dependency of this transformation. So it is important to know how to use this diagram in order to design a heat treatment for a some alloy that will yield to a desired room temperature. For example, if we take the example, agar hum kisi material ke strength tensile strength ka example lete hain for iron carbon alloy at a eutectoid, that is 0.76% of carbon can be varied between the approximate 700 megapascal and 2000 megapascal, and that depending upon the heat treatment of the applied. So that for understanding the versatility of the metallic material, it is lying in the wide range of the mechanical property they possess. So koi bhi material, metallic material hai, uski jo sustainability hai ya versatility, versatile hai wo material, wo apni properties ke regarding wo versatile hota hai, and that accessible management by the various means is happening. So these strengthening mechanism that we talked in the earlier, and that the development of the microstructure in both the single and the two phase alloy basically involved, and that the some kind of phase transformation is that alternation in the number and the characters of the phases is to be studied. So the in this particular we will understand the phase transformation principle that we discussed earlier, and now we will discuss the solid phases, that transformation that occur instantaneous consideration, and that is dependence of reaction, that is progress of the time or the transformation rate. That transformation rate is not mentioned in the iron carbon diagram, and that's why we are studying this kind of transformation diagram as well, to understand the time dependency of the transformation. So let us begin with the phase transformation, So it is the variety and very important in the processing of the material to usually they involve some alternation of the microstructure. So for the purpose so this isothermal diagram basically is nothing to understanding the phase transformation of processing the material, and this is basically involved some alternation of the microstructure that we talked about in this. So let's begin to understand the particular microstructure property changes in our carbon alloys that is relating to the particular isothermal transformation diagram, which is happening in the iron carbon diagram as well. So let's begin to understand this first. So just an introduction that some of the understanding which is being taking place, the principle of solid state transformation are now extended to applied some specifically iron carbon alloy in term of relationship between the heat treatment and the development of the microstructure and the mechanical properties. So this system basically has chosen because of the particular so this particular mechanical properties understanding, this system is chosen because of this familiar and a wide variety of the microstructures and the mechanical property are possible in this particular iron carbon or the steel alloy. So for understanding this, we are considering this particular reaction that is containing the austenite transformation which transform into the two solid that is the alpha ferrite and the cementite, and that transformation is basically showing the percentage of the carbon in this, and when it's heating and the cooling, it transforming the showing the percentage of the alpha ferrite of this particular and the combination up to Fe3C, the cementite. So this particular is fundamental, is this consideration is basically nothing, just iron carbide eutectoid reaction. This particular reaction is the iron carbide eutectoid reaction, which is the fundamental to the development of microstructure in steel alloy. So iske behalf pe steel alloy ke andar microstructure development hota hai, and with respect to the cooling, upon cooling austenite, ye particular reaction wahi bata raha hai ki when we cooling from the austenite, that is the gamma having an intermediate carbon concentration. So that transformation to a ferrite phase, as you can see in this particular ferrite phase, and having much lower carbon content, that is 0.02% basically, and also containing the cementite, that is 0.67%, with a much higher carbon concentration, that particular is showing here. And that the perlite is one microstructural product of this transformation that we talked in earlier lecture, is transformation of the perlite by this particular combination is showing. So this formation is basically demonstration in this particular figure. So that understanding of propagation of this particular ferrite and the cementite in this particular scenario with respect to the austenite, that transformation basically related to the perlite. So to understanding this, the in this the temperature play a very vital role and the important role in this, the rate of that particular austenite to perlite transformation. So how it comes in that scenario, so what we do, we will just take the example of this particular figure, and to understand that this particular time temperature transformation basically. So this particular temperature dependence for iron carbon alloy eutectoid composition indicating in this particular figure, which plotting the S shape, basically this is the S shape is showing here for the various of percentage transformation. So this particular S curve is nothing, just understanding of this particular behavior So this S-shaped curve of the particular percentage transformation versus the logarithm of the time, that the percentage of the particular perlite with respect to the time logarithm, and showing in this particular graph, and at the three different temperature range, that showing here 600, 650, 675 degrees centigrade. And this particular each curve, the data were collected after rapidly cooling a specimen composed of 100% austenite to the temperature indicated. So that temperature was maintained constant throughout the course of the reaction in this particular. So a more convenient way of representing both the time temperature dependency of this particular transformation is in the bottom portion of this particular system, that showing here, and this particular, right? And hence the vertical and the horizontal axis are representing the temperature for this particular logarithm system. In this particular, you can see this particular figure. This particular figure basically is nothing, just to understanding the vertical, the representing the both the time and temperature dependency transformation, and this particular bottom portion. And the vertical horizontal axis are basically representatively temperature and logarithm time, that is showing here. So that the particular time and the percentage of the pearl austenite with respect to that time logarithm is representing here. So in this particular, as it is mentioned also here, that the point, the vertical axis, horizontal axis representing the temperature and time, the two solid curves are plotted on this representation, and one represent the time required at each temperature for the initiation or start. That particular is showing initiation and the start basically. And that representation is also showing the beginning of that and the end of that particular transformation at that point. So the transformation is the transformation that basically showing the dashed line in this, the curve that corresponded to the 50% of the transformation is completed. So that particular curve which is showing. So these curves were generated from a series of the plot of the percentage transformation, that versus of the logarithm of the time taken over the range of the temperature. So S-shaped curve basically at the 760, that particular curve is showing, that is the, you can see here, that particular dotted line is showing the 50% completion of the transformation, and that particular say 675 degrees centigrade basically. At that point is the transformation is S shape, is curve is mentioned. And the upper portion of this particular figure in this particular range is showing the transformate. And the interpretation of this particular diagram, we can understand the first that the eutectoid temperature at 727 degrees centigrade at this figure, that is 727 degrees centigrade indicated by a horizontal line, and the above the eutectoid and the particular for the all timely, only the austenite will exist at that particular portion. You can see the stable austenite is shown here. So this indicating in this particular figure, so the austenite to perlite transformation will occur only if an alloy is supercooled below this eutectoid reaction. So this particular transformation is the time, there is the temperature, in temperature dependent. So start and finish curve are nearly parallel from this particular. You can see the start and the end curve basically is as at the starting, you can see they are in the parallel, and that basically showing approaches to the eutectoid lines, and left of the transformation start curve only austenite, and will present whereas to right of the finish curve. So only perlite will exist in between them. So this is the particular transformation and where the perlite is basically existing in between them. And that is the shorter this time in the higher rate. So the particular figure, that is your particular figure showing the transformations of this at temperature just below the eutectoid corresponding to the degree. So very long time for the 10 to the power 5, as you can see, as required for the 50% of transformation. So and therefore the particular transformation, therefore the reaction rate is very slow. The transformation rate increases and with decreasing the temperature such as 550 to 40 degree centigrade. And that transformation basically about 3s is required for the reaction to go for the 50% of the completion. So the rate temperature behavior is apparently contradicting in this particular basically equation. And this particular diagram is constraint imposed of this particular thing. First, this particular plot is valid only for the iron carbon alloy of eutectoid composition basically. And for other composition, the curve will have a different configuration. So in addition, these plots are accurate only for transformation in which the transformation of the alloy is held basically. And that particular held at that particular. So the condition of the constant temperature are termed as the isothermal. So means the constant temperature is basically related to the term as the isothermal. And that plot is such as refers to the isothermal transformation. So this is the particular isothermal transformation. So that particular transformation is representing the time temperature dependency of this particular transformation as shown in the figure. The dash curve is corresponding to 50% transformation is completed, that is showing here. And the interpretation of this transformation is noted that the eutectoid temperature, that is 1341 degree Fahrenheit, is indicated by the horizontal line at the temperature above the eutectoid portion, that is showing the initiation of the transformation is taking place, and that the austenitic transformation is taking place to the perlite transformation, and that the time is necessary for this transformation to begin and then the end of the dependency of the transformation. So that the transformation from this phase to this phase basically, this phase to this phase, that the particular transformation is happening. So that transformation is basically indicating in this by the, that is presenting with the time dependency, and that is how this particular diagram is known as the isothermal transformation diagram. That means representing that constant temperature, that is representing the isothermal, and that isothermal transformation diagram also sometimes known as the time temperature transformation triple T diagram, as these are the actual isothermal heat treatment curve that is basically is showing here, that is showing by this particular A, B and C and D point, that is showing the super promised of the isothermal transformation eutectoid iron carbon alloy system. And you can see here the very rapid cooling of the austenite, that you can see the very rapid cooling of the degradation of this particular rapid cooling of the austenite is basically is showing the temperature is indicated by near vertical line of the AB, that the particular AB. And the isothermal treatment at this temperature is presented by the horizontal segment BCD, that is the constant temperature, that is the isothermal. Of course, the time increase from the left to right, as you can see, the left to right time is showing here. And the particular transformation austenite to perlite begin at the intersection point of the C, that the transformation basically, that the dotted line is showing the middle phase, that the half of the portion is transformed from the austenite to perlite is showing here. So these particular things are basically happening. And the transformation of the austenite to perlite began at the interaction at the point C, that is showing in this particular figure. and the completion is about 15 seconds, that is showing, and that particular is showing up across this 15s. So that understanding of this and that particular approx approximately above the development, the second, the transformation is basically taken into the seconds, and that leading to approximately 3.5 seconds as well, as it reaches the completion of about 15 seconds. So that particular it amount to 15 seconds. So this transformation will take 3 seconds about to complete the 50%, and about the whole completion is about to 15 seconds approx. And this particular corresponding to the point D that the transformation is basically showing here. Okay, so as you can see, the microstructure at various times during the progression of the reaction is showing. So the thickness or ratio of the ferrite and cementite layer in the perlite is approximately 8 to 1, and however that is the 8 to 1, and that the transformation of the microstructure development we discussed earlier in the lectures as well. So this is nothing, just to understanding the how much time the transformation is taking place. So that basically the transformation is taking place only the 3 seconds from the austenite to perlite, and for the whole completion is maximum taking the 15 second approx to completion of this transformation from the austenite to the perlite. And this particular figure is showing at that temperature point absolute layer, the thickness dependent on the temperature, with the isothermal transformation is allowed to occur. So the temperature, at the temperature just below the eutectoid, and that the particular line which is showing the below the eutectoid, and with the isothermal transformation, the constant temperature transformation is basically allowed to occur. So at this temperature just below the eutectoid, we have relatively thick layer of the both the alpha ferrite and the Fe3C phase are produced, as you can see in this particular transformation is taking place. So this transformation is showing, and the microstructure is called the coarse perlite. Basically coarse perlite is basically happening. So this particular coarse perlite is showing, and the region at which it form indicating to the right of the composition curve, that particular showing the coarse perlite of coarse perlite region. So at this temperature the diffusion rate at relatively high, such that during the particular, so this transformation is basically, you can see here the coarse perlite is happening, and that at the right side of this particular figure. And at the temperature just below the eutectoid, we talked about this, the alpha ferrite basically confining into the particular combination of this Fe3C and relating to the coarse perlite, and the region at which it formed, it indicated to the right of the completion of this particular coarse. So this particular temperature diffusion rate at relatively high, and such that during the particular transformation is showing, and the diffusion relatively long distance, so which result in the formation of the thick lamina with the decreasing in the temperature, and the carbon diffusion rate basically you can see the decrease, and the layer become progressive in the thinner. So the thin layer structure was produced basically evincing of the 540 degrees centigrade approx, that you can see, and which is showing the particular finer perlite at this is indicating in this particular figure, and that is the dependent, that the particular material is showing the dependency of this particular you can see the transformation. And this particular thin layer structure produced at the vicinity of the 540 degree centigrade is termed the fine perlite, and that fine perlite is basically we discussed earlier, and this is the particular photomicrograph of the coarse and the fine perlite is showing here. So for the carbon alloy system, basically this is for the coarse one, A, the first figure is coarse one, and this is B is the perlite. So this is the perlite, and where is your coarse structure? That is the coarse structure that is showing here. That means the larger structure and the finer structure. So in this, the particular mechanical property of lamina thickness is dependency, and the microstructure of this particular coarse and the fine perlite for eutectite composition are showing in this particular figure. So you can understand the iron carbon alloy of other composition of pro-eutectoid phase, that is the ferrite or cementite, will coexistence with the perlite as we discussed. And the additional curve corresponding to the pro-eutectoid transformation also must be included on the isothermal transformation diagram. So for the understanding this, we understand all the data regarding to this. And in the next class, we will discuss in the detail how this transformation is basically happening in the detailing as well, with the another scenario, that is the cooling curve. So for that, I am holding this lecture. Thank you.